Hello everyone, we're just going to start in a minute and wait for a few more people to join. All right, I think we can begin. Hello everyone and welcome to today's live session by SEO. I'm Arsai Spandana and I'm an associate editor at SEO. Our main story today concerns the Bilkis Banu case. To give you a brief background of this case, it originated back in 2002 during the Godhra riots in the state of Gujarat. Ms. Bilkis Banu and her family members were returning in a cart back to her village and they were stopped by a mob of around 20 men. Ms. Banu was subjected to gang rape. Her family members were assaulted and murdered, including her infant daughter. Ms. Banu was 21 years old and was 5 months pregnant at the time. She tried to file an FIR in the Gujarat local police station, but faced a lot of resistance from the Gujarat mechanisms. So, in 2003, she moved the National Human Rights Commission and the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court ordered a CBI probe into the matter in 2003. A month later, based on the report of the CBI, the Supreme Court, all the accused were arrested and a special bench began hearing the matter in the trial. The trial was conducted in Mumbai, Maharashtra, because Ms. Banu claimed that she had security threats for the trial to go on unhindered in Gujarat. A special bench heard the matter and they convicted 11 out of the 20 odd accused men. And 7 of them were acquitted because there was not sufficient evidence to support their conviction. In 2017, the Bombay High Court accepted all the acquittals and also quashed all the acquittals of the 7 that were let go because not enough evidence was available to convict them. And all of them were sentenced to life imprisonment. In 2019, the Supreme Court ordered the government of Gujarat to pay 50 lakh rupees to Ms. Banu and also give her a job for security and for her life and family to sustain going forward. Now, the main case in the current plea before the Supreme Court originates in 2022. One of the accused, Mr. Radhesham Shah, filed for his remission before the Gujarat High Court earlier in 2022. The Gujarat High Court refused his petition, saying that since the case was decided by a court in Maharashtra, the Maharashtra court was the appropriate court to hear the matter. The Supreme Court heard his, Ms. Sham went to the Supreme Court and the Supreme Court essentially stated that though the Maharashtra court heard the matter and made the decision, the crime occurred in the state of Gujarat and so the Gujarat government was the appropriate authority to make a decision in this case. So a Gujarat government formed an expert committee and after investigation, the committee unanimously agreed to release all the convicted persons in this case. And last year on August 15th, on the eve of our 75th Independence Day, under the Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav initiative, all the accused were released from jail. Now, what is remission? Remission is essentially the shortening of a sentence without changing its character. The Supreme Court has previously clarified that this is not a right that prisoners enjoy, but rather a discretion of the executive wing of the government. As soon as all the convicted persons in this case were released, there was a lot of criticism faced and a lot of people, including the petitioners in the present case and the opposing parties, opposed this decision by the Gujarat government, stating that according to the guidelines released by the Ministry of Home Affairs before the release of these convicts, they clearly stated that persons who were convicted for the crimes of rape and murder could not be released. The Gujarat government, however, took the stance that the policy that applied for the remission of the convicted people in this present case was the policy of 1992, because this was the policy that existed when they were originally convicted. Today, a bench comprising of Justice K.M. Joseph and Justice B.V. Nagaratna heard the parties in the case. Solicitor General Tushar Mehta tried to push the matter to another day, but Justice K.M. Joseph, who seemed keen on completing and concluding the hearings in this case before he retires in June, said that all the parties must file all of their submissions before April 18th, and the case will be heard again at 2 p.m. on the 18th of April this year. What will happen in the court and what will the bench decide in the current case with regards to the remission of the convicted persons in this case? Stay tuned to SEO to know more. Thank you.